So, welcome. You are at the Got the Sing Along Workshop, right? If you're not thinking that you're supposed to be here, then you have a chance to leave. But we have the handouts on the chairs, and there's plenty of chairs still up front. Originally, my hope as music coordinator at Seattle Betsuin was to have our new Seattle-Tacoma service book ready to distribute by this weekend, but unfortunately, I don't have it done. But it's still my goal to have it done before the end of this year and distribute to the Northwest District Temples. And I want to acknowledge Donna Sasaki, who's been helping me. Is she in the room? Yes. So this handout is a little preliminary view of what I hope some of the service book will be like, where we are trying to preserve some of the Japanese lyrics of some of the tunes that were originally in Japanese and use the Tacoma English translation as well for a couple of them. A couple of them are Donna Sasaki's compositions. And the reason I wanted Rinban here to start was that part of the service book project was that he was hoping to republish Linda Castro's music. And Linda originally published in 1990 six gathas for Buddhist children. And I actually have my show and tell over there. I wasn't prepared. But the original book was a light green color. The teacher's book was a pink color book. And all of the music in that book was republished by Tacoma in their 2008 Dharma School service book. So essentially, if we republished Tacoma's music, most of Linda's music would be republished that way. And then Tacoma's books have become out of print, and we wanted also to help them republish the music and distribute more widely. So that was the goal. So the first piece that I chose is actually the one piece that was not republished by Tacoma, which is a round called Silent in the Temple. And I don't know, Rinban, would you want to say anything?
I wanted you to hear it, then you could go to the other workshop.
Well, as I remember, our children were very young when these gathas were composed, and we had a children's service, and so these gathas were mostly composed for the children's service. A Special Place was one of them, and when I went to Hawaii, they were singing it. They thought, you know, the lyrics fit living in Hawaii so well. An island in the sea. The island in the sea in the children's service was a zabuto on the floor that they visit every week. So these are just very, very simple gathas, and I hope that you'll enjoy them. I think that you will get great pleasure out of knowing that her gathas have been used and enjoyed and are continuing to be used and enjoyed.
So this is the original green book, and the pink book is the teacher. So Masatabi Kuni is the leader of our Seattle Betsuin ukulele band, and I think what we want to do is play the tune, right, on the piano with you, and you can follow along, and then we do want to try it as a round.
Thank you.
these are Linda's instructions in the original book that we're dividing into two groups. And there's a bold number one at the treble clef at the beginning, right above silent. And then there's a bold number two in the third measure above as. And first group is supposed to start, and the second group is supposed to start at the number two and keep going. And then when you finish, to end together, group one sings through the whole song plus the first two measures. That's her instruction. Why don't we first all sing it together? But that's the concept of the round, okay? We'll have the ukulele band do sing. Now, hopefully you all recognize the tune because you don't have the notes. And you're all singing also, right? So this was yours.
Sing a song, sing out loud.
with, I hope I have this list right, Sun Kioi, Sayaka Aoyama, Rena Warwick, Marlene Okada, and is Ann Oxrider here? Absent. Greg Oxrider, Gail Kaminishi, Tomizu Moto, Amy Shabuya, Elsie Taniguchi. Thank you very much. And Reverend Harry Gray. So while they're moving their chairs around, many of you have seen this one, Gassho Around the World from Tacoma, 2010. Yeah, they were kind enough to distribute this to us at a Northwest District Convention. So, next one is from this one, but the Japanese version is from this one.
Thank you. welcome home.
Someone did a great job in the English translation on this. Those of you on the Tacoma Gatha Committee, could you please stand? Who else worked with you from Tacoma on the translations? Second voice line, and there's a flute part, so Jim's going to help out on this one too. Okay, so I think
so that the melody line is actually
see,
the
I'm
bottom.
Not looking at yours, I'm looking at the camera.
At the bottom with the three staffs, the top is the flute, the second one in the middle is the actual counterpart, but the real melody is the bottom one, so that's what you're referring to.
Pick a side of the room. I know you know the counter line.
Caroline's there, Melody in the bottom, staff is over there, and I'll play with these guys this time. I'll play with you guys the first time.
Originally, Donna, right, we're supposed to do it all together, and the second time around, they add the counter line?
I believe so.
So you'll get a chance, let's all do the main melody together, and then on the repeat, Masa's side is going to try the counter line with Jim on the flute, okay? We'll take it from the top. I ended up not just distributing at the registration. But I was thinking about asking people to tell us what's your all-time favorite Gatha and what's your favorite Gatha of the Tacoma Gathas. And I pretty much know that if we surveyed our Seattle Sangha, the We Are One is our favorite Tacoma Gatha. So we had to. But I think it would be nice at the end of this, if you all might want to think about what your all-time favorite Gatha is. That's, you know, all these years of Gathas. And maybe we can share what we think. But in the meantime, this is We Are One.
Can we stand up for this one?
Sure.
We don't know. It's easy.
Harry says we have to practice first, I mean. You can listen. Who knows this Gatha? Can you please raise your hand?
Please stand in the front.
There's enough of you to intersperse. So we'll play it once through and then we'll play it again. Okay?
Thank you.
others, Orange County, Gothenburg is being sold there today. Does anybody know if the Orange County service book is being sold in the bookstore? Anyway, one of the other reasons we decided we needed to republish our own Seattle Tacoma service book is because although his committee did select some of Donna's music, not all of her music was chosen, including Not We Are One. But there are some of Donna's other compositions in the Orange County service book. So there is an already published one. Actually, Reverend Marvin was very generous. When Jim and I were in Los Angeles last year, we met with him in Orange County. And he said, "You're crazy, Kemi. You think you're going to publish a service book in time for February? It took us 6 years to do ours." Might be hard for me. Emiko, I might need to join the Dharma line. So I think Emiko and the Berkeley people might be the only ones who know this gatha. It's not call and response, no. Do you know it?
Well,
I'll play it. Except if I don't get the rhythm right, then you'll get mad.
Bye. Thank you.
Is that right?
So the last one I chose was Hotsuke Sama wa. How many know it in Japanese? Do the Tacoma people know it in English? Tacoma people know the English lyrics? Do you sing it much there? Yeah, I mean, actually, in Seattle, we haven't done the English yet, I don't think. Maybe the choir helped me proofread it, but, so you're all in the same boat, pretty much, with the English.
Thank you.
often because it's one of the selections in the Purple Book that's a choral arrangement. So our Seattle Metropolitan Choir's done it in parts, and the men sort of alternate with the women in that arrangement in the 1994 book. It's in there. And then the Tacoma has translated it nicely into English. Any questions or comments? It is tricky. I mean, I think the original tempo is probably even a tad faster than that. Yeah, right? You want to try it again? Nobody asked. Any general questions about the whole thing? We have about 10 minutes. Or anyone want to say what their all-time favorite Gotha is? Okay, well, Mima and Castro like Seiya and Ganjin's journey.
Yeah. You know that G.I. actually had a part in Ganjin's journey for the kids to sing. And it's really cute when they do it.
So, Ellis Fukushima is the choir director at Palo Alto Buddhist Temple. We're really happy to have her here too. And I was talking to her, and also to my mother's cousin Agnes Sasaki is here from Oakland, Reverend Harry's temple, and her husband Dick. And Agnes is belongs to Oakland, but she sings in the San Jose Betsuin Choir. And I was fortunate to be able to arrange this last year to attend the choir festival that was hosted by Sacramento Betsuin last spring. And you had six choirs formally participating. They've been trying to do that every couple of years. Fresno, Mountain View, Palo Alto, San Francisco, Sacramento, and San Jose. And according to Alice and Agnes, the plan is that San Jose was going to host, but they're remodeling in 2016, so Mountain View has kindly offered to host the 2016 Choir Festival with San Jose's help. And they told me I could tell you all that if we were ambitious, we could have a Northwest District Choir present our convention theme song at the 2016 Choir Festival. And if people are interested, and you don't have to be in the mass choir, sort of fundraising and learning our convention song and going down to Mountain View.
You
want to
explain the format?
Yeah, I'm going to
come
through.
So
we have this. Come up to the microphone, please.
I'm loud.
I'm here with loud. The people can't hear. It's not your voice. It's very hard.
So the format that we used in the past two choir festivals is that each choir comes and they present one or two songs, just their own choir. And then each choir contributes a song that they would like everybody to learn. And then we sing it all in a mass choir. So it's really a lot of fun. And what we do is in the morning, everybody has their warm-ups, and then we practice for the mass choir. And in the afternoon, after the temple serves a wonderful lunch, we then all sing together. And it's really a nice thing to have, and we really enjoy it. And last year, I think we had about 130 participants, which doesn't leave much room in the hondo for other people to come in and, you know, listen, but Sacramento had their own fan club, so it was kind of, it was a lot different, you know. It's really a nice thing to come in. We hope that maybe you will come. It would really be great.
I meant to do this earlier, but I don't have my list. But I did want to acknowledge Etsu Osaki from Portland. Could you please stand? So Portland hosted last year's Northwest District Convention, if you all didn't know. And back in May, I unfortunately wasn't at that convention, but I knew because I was helping between choir members attending the convention to learn May Peace Prevail, because that was the gatha that Etsu's temple had chosen as the mass choir song that the Northwest District members would present. And so she and I had been in touch by email. So she said, okay, Kemi, is your temple's hosting? And she emailed me in May, and she goes, are you gonna do a mass choir? And I'm like, yeah, I am, except we're gonna be singing and learning the convention theme song, which we haven't written yet. So I said, Etsu, I promise you, I will have it written by September and send it out. And so thanks to Jim and Dennis, we got things done by the time I could try to pass it out for other temples to learn. And I remember Donna Sasaki telling me that a lot of her compositions she did driving from Washington to Eastern Washington, Oregon, oh no, Idaho, Oregon, that's where your family's from, Reverend Fujimoto's temple. In the car, she would be composing and thinking about her songs. And sure enough, as Jim and I were driving back from California, I was trying to work on these lyrics for the convention theme song back in August, and then I just couldn't quite finish. And so when I got back to Seattle, I said, Dennis, can you please help me? I can't finish these lyrics. And I actually have the same problem with an Earth Day gatha. And so I might actually ask Donna and Michiko and whoever is willing to help me finish the lyrics. I have the tune for a gatha I'm entitling Precious Earth. The tune was something I wrote in college as an assignment in a music theory class. And I had this light bulb go off and I ran to the temple. I said, Rinban, I have an idea for an Earth Day gatha for you. It's this tune I wrote in college, but I need to write lyrics to it. And so that is partway done. And so I'm hoping I can finish the lyrics for April, for your Earth Day. And I'm hoping that, you know, some of this music, DI's joined the Dharma line, and some of these other pieces will be included in the gatha. But Kent Masuda, as you all probably know, composed Shinran's Family. And we sing that quite a bit in Seattle, and he's given permission to include that in our new service book. And so we'll have some new material. But then some of these that Tacoma has already published, and some of the combination of Japanese and English translations. So my hope, I don't know if it can be enduring for 20 years like the Purple Service Book, but our hope is that it will have quite a bit of music. I'm going to try to cut down the pages by having a separate accompanist book so that we can just put more song sheets like you're using today, and just save the space on the piano score staff so we can put more songs in. That's my hope. Reverend Harry, you want to say anything? I told him he didn't have to prepare at all for this workshop. So thank you for participating. Thank you, Jim and the ukulele band, for participating.
Thank you, Kemi.
Yeah, you can go. There are more buskers that are going to come out to play in the next break. So thank you very much, everyone. I hope you enjoyed singing the music.